Thank you. section. Next, we can click the build icon, and once that process was complete, we can click the execute icon, which brings up a new terminal window. That means it was time to connect the ground and the utilized GPIO pin to an LED with current limiting resistor on a breadboard. And as you can see, the blink code worked without a problem. In this case, the only difference to an Arduino circuit is that the Raspberry Pi uses 3.3 volts voltage levels instead of the 5 volts voltage levels of an Arduino. Next, let's add an input.